Welcome back to Design Bundle's YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal. Today, I'm gonna show you guys how to make your very own water tracker, water bottle. So what I'm gonna show you guys is how to layer adhesive vinyl. So we've got a couple different layers going on here, and then we have the front and the back of our water bottle. Now, what's really cool with these designs, when you guys get these, they're one plus credit, several designs to choose from. You're gonna get your water tracker for your back, and then you're also going to get your design. So as you guys can see, this one has two layers, and then this one over here has three layers. So as you guys can also see, the backs are the exact same. So whenever you guys get these, you can definitely just download. It has two downloads included with each one, the front and the back. You could definitely just download one of the backs and then all of your front. So that's what I did here. I've went ahead and cut everything out with my Cricut Maker 3. You could definitely use whatever die cutting machine that you guys have. A few more things you're gonna want is some transfer tape of some sort, as well as a squeegee and a water bottle. Lots of different water bottles to choose from. You can find them at the Dollar Tree, all over the place, as well as Amazon. Me and my daughter found these. We want to refresh our water bottles. It's a brand new year. Everybody's trying to set goals. And so we always make ourselves these water bottles. And so I thought, hey, it's a brand new year, brand new day. Let's go ahead and make fresh water bottles. So we found these. And what's really cool is we can reuse these because the filters too. So we cannot waste so much plastic with the water bottles that we buy in the store. So I'm going to use these today. They're super cool looking. Really love the way that they look. I'll link these down below if you guys want to check them out as well. They're a little bit pricey. I think they were around 20 bucks, but then think about, you know, not having to buy all those water bottles because they have the filters, and I believe they come with like two refills inside. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to start with our back layer first. So another thing that you may want to get is a clean cloth that is lint free and maybe some rubbing alcohol. So let's go ahead and start by removing this, which looks like it should be pretty simple. What I want to do next is clean this really well. You really want to use some rubbing alcohol or, like I said, a nice, smooth, clean cloth. I don't have any rubbing alcohol out here today, so I'm just going to use this cloth here to remove any sort of oils. And I'm going to clean one side to the next because of my hands. So I'm just looking because this one has a design in the front. I want to flip it over so that way I know my back and I can keep this design nice and even. All right, so now that we have our water bottle nice and clean, the next thing you can do is take an extra squeegee. These ones are perfect that have these two lines in the middle. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna lay your bottle right on top of that. So that really works out with any of these bottles. You can just lay it there and it's gonna help stabilize that. So I'm just gonna make sure I'm in the center here. As you guys can see, I've got a max fill line. And we're gonna take our first piece. Now I've already applied a piece of transfer tape on this one. And I'm gonna go ahead and just rub it in really well to make sure it is picking everything up. All right, once we've done that, we could go ahead and flip it over, remove our backing, just like so. Now today I am using StarCraft. This is their permanent. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this nice and centered. I'm folding it like a taco. I'm gonna figure out the center of my bottle, about like so, and then drop it down. You can go down one side and then the other. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of rub everything in with my hands and just kind of smooth everything out. Next, you could take your little squeegee and go over all of those pieces just to make sure everything is adhered. All right. And then we're going to peel it at an angle. And there you go so far. How cute is that? I think I got just a little bit crooked, but I think that looks really good. I love this design and I love the chunkiness of it. To find the exact measurements, I just took my ruler here and figured out, you know, about how big I wanted to be. So I knew I wanted to be about 3.5 inches wide, and then I got my width from there. All right, let's go ahead and apply the back to this one as well. I'm gonna take that same piece of transfer tape and just go right on top of this one and smooth everything out. And then we're just gonna go ahead and rub it in to pick it up. Flip flip it over and peel. I'm gonna do the same thing, try to go down like a taco. Now I've already used this transfer tape, so it's wanting to roll, so I'm just gonna get control of it and try to center it up. I'm gonna go ahead and smooth out one side and then the next. Rub everything in with my fingers, come back with that squeegee, and just smooth everything out. All right, grab it at an angle and peel. And there you guys have it. I love it. I do love how the white pops off here better than the black does, but I definitely wanted to show you guys both ways. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the front of our design. I'm gonna go over with that cloth one more time just to make sure everything is nice and clean. And then we're gonna start layering our designs. So we're gonna drop this down and pick it up. Now, there's a couple different ways that you could do this. You could definitely apply this one first and then come back in with the next layer. Or we could pick this layer up, come back, pick up this layer, and then pick up this layer. Now, I've already applied a piece of transfer tape because I had it what was on hand, so I won't be able to do that with this. But I can show you with this, but you would just continue to go on until it was one solid sticker, per se, and then you would apply it. Or, you could do it individual. The reason why I for sure would like to do it with these two layers is because if I do it with just this, I don't really know where I need to align it. So this is the exact length, if you will, of my design. I want to at least have these two layers go down at the same time. All right, so I'm just burnishing these pieces here, flipping it over and peeling. All right, so what I'm gonna do is very carefully, I'm gonna line this down, and I'm going to try and line everything up. You guys can kind of see that there. Now, I don't want to drop this wishing down because I don't want this to stick to my countertop because it will come off on my countertop. So what you can do is if you have overage like this, you could take a piece of parchment because it will not stick to the parchment. And then we can continue to smooth everything out. So I want to pick this piece up just like so. And then I need to rub the pink piece because the white piece is already attached. All right, so as you guys can see, that did not stick to the parchment. Move that out of our way. We're gonna flip it upside down. And now, as you guys can see, we have both of those layers on one. Now, once again, I could have came back if I would not have already put this transfer on, and I could have picked up my last layer and then put it down as one. So that's something you guys can do. And once again, you could put these down in individual layers as well. So I'm going to line this up, just making sure I'm straight. I go down like a taco, and then I'm just gonna smooth everything out with my fingers. Just like that. I could come back in with my squeegee here just to really rub everything in. When you're working with mugs, water bottles, anything that's gonna get washed, highly recommend that you wait at least 48 to 72 hours to allow this to really adhere and bond to the tumbler. Water bottle, if you will. All right, so now what we're gonna do is peel at an angle. Just like so. So let's add on our last layer. All right. Just going to hover above and line everything up. Just like that. Smooth everything down. Isn't this design super cute? I love the chunkiness of it. And these colors just went together very well. And once again, I am using a permanent. This would be a great beginner project if you guys just purchased a Cricut for Christmas. So as you guys can see, how cute is this, right? I absolutely love the way that this one came out. Adorable. So let me go ahead and wrap up the next. And there you guys have it. Super easy water tracker water bottles. So these are one plus credit. Once again, several different designs to choose from. You guys can tell this one's for me, this one's for my daughter. I really do like the way the white popped off here with these colors a whole lot better than the black, but this is a great example to show you guys if you're trying to determine what colors to do your water bottles. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.